And there was a Bible on our porch. I think there's a Bible in every room in our house, but there's a Bible there on the porch. And she opened it up and she shared some Bible verses with me and explained it to me in a way that my little 10-year-old mind could understand it. And but the one Bible verse that stood out was the one we all learned in Vacation Bible School, John 3:16. But she read it to me different. She said, look right here. It says, for God so loves Johnny that he gave his only son, that if Johnny will trust in him, Johnny will have everlasting life.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
That was the coolest thing I'd ever heard of.
Yeah, man.
God loved me enough to send Jesus. Man. So that day on that little porch in Decatur, Georgia, just that afternoon after school, I said a little prayer. My mom led me in asking Jesus to forgive me of my sin and to walk with me all the days of my life. We went from just being another mom and son on Thomas Road in Decatur, Georgia, to being brothers and sister in him. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Ever salvation purchased of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed. I keep watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. On January 12th of 1981, I came home from work early that day. I was still living with my folks, and I was 19 years old, and I got to the house and called my mom and didn't hear anywhere, looked around, didn't find her, and figured she'd gone to have lunch with some friends or something. So I grabbed myself a sandwich and took it downstairs to a little studio my dad had helped build in the basement of our house. And I had lunch down there and messed around with some music for a little while, and then I grabbed myself a little afternoon nap. And a bit later, I woke up to a commotion, realized my dad had gotten home, so I headed up the stairs to see him, and about halfway up those steps, I heard him call my name, and I knew something was wrong. And I rushed upstairs and walked to my mom and dad's room, and my mom is laying there on the bed, and she's unconscious. And I'm trying to think, what in the world? I couldn't find her. She wasn't here when I... And then I remembered I didn't check that little half bath in their bedroom. The light was off, and I didn't think to open the door. Because everybody knew, all of us knew that when my mom was at home, after lunch, she'd go to that little half bath and have her quiet time, read her Bible. And she'd have her prayer time, and she'd pray for her husband, Jim. 36 years they'd been married, and she loved my dad. And my brother and my sister, she'd pray for us. And she'd pray for other brothers and sisters in Christ and missionaries around the world, and which meant she was praying for y'all. We got her to the hospital and realized she had had cerebral aneurysm. And she passed away later that night with doctors and friends around us. And they explained to us what had happened. But this is not a story about, a family that lost their sweet mama. It's a story about God's grace. The grace that God showed my father, that he didn't come home and find his wife of 36 years deceased. And what a tragic scene that would have been. And the grace that God showed me, this very young 19-year-old, that I didn't come home and find my mom in a situation I would not have known what to do. God's grace is sufficient in all things, in all situations, no matter where you find yourself in life. Those folks who are viewing this video, no matter where they find themselves in life, God's grace is sufficient. What a wonderful testimony to be able to say that I have that blessed assurance in Him. Sing it with me. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior. Savior, all the day long, praising my Savior, all the day long.
What a blessing, John Barry.
Yes, what a blessing,
John Barry. Yeah.